welcome to my channel. If you're a returning subscriber and if you're new here, welcome to my channel. My name is Marilyn. So I did do a Dubois street haul video a couple of months ago. I actually did that video months ago. This is going to be a full face first impression of the things I did get from Dubois street. For the most part, most of these things I haven't touched because I really did want to do a full face using these items just to show you guys what I feel about them, how they go, how they apply, yada yada yada, things like that. Some of these items I have actually already used. Like, I want to say like two things I've used. When I do get to the items that I have used, I will mention it. Sorry if I sound a little bit groggy, I literally just woke up. My weekdays have been pretty hectic lately, so I haven't been able to film during the weekdays, so I am filming on the weekend. If you hear like a lot of background noise, I do apologize in advance. With that being said, let's jump right into the video, and we are going to start with brows. I always start with my brows. Like, I don't know how anyone does the makeup like any other way. Like, I've seen people who do their face first and then they do their brows, and I'm like, how? If you can do your makeup by not starting with your brows, like, I envy you. I'm using the Me Now concealer pencil. So this brow pencil is very nice. It's just a bit darker than I would like gravitate towards. I got this brow gel. It's really oily. Try like just do the tail of my brow. This brow pencil has a concealer. I used this concealer in my Halloween looks, the tutorials I did. Then I used this to map out my face and where like I was going to paint and things like that. That's what I use it for. I haven't used it for my brows, but I'm gonna try right now. And then I did get two of these concealers that look like Illegal Pro Conceal. They say Iman New Up Pro Concealer. I like the applicator. It's like a lip wand, which is pretty cool. So I'm gonna use this on top of this concealer I used. So something weird just happened. When I went to blend in the concealer, it like, do you see that? The brush picks up all the products. I don't know what's happening. So I'm gonna warm it at the back of my hand and then use the brush to apply the concealer. Hopefully that works. I'm very thankful that I used this first. Let's just do this. Hopefully that will help it. So this concealer is crap. No. I decided I'm going to use the foundation to clean up my brows. I didn't buy a brow gel, so I have this clear mascara that I'll be using. I think that's as good as we're gonna get for the brows. They look super brown on camera there, but they're not as bold in real life. Moving on with it, I really wanted to use this as a primer, but seeing as how shite this is, I think I'm going to go in and use this concealer quad. I've been using this shade here. Like, I absolutely love this shade for contouring. So I'm going to go in with this color here and put that on my lid. Oh, this is nice. Best part is it actually sticks to my lid. So I'm going to set this with the powder I got for my skin shade, and it's this powder here. I did get three eyeshadow palettes, so I got this one, I also got this one, and this one. This one I have been using. Like, obviously you can tell that it's very loved. See, I already hit pan on one of them. I absolutely love this palette. It made me wonder, this is a fake one. If the quality of this palette is this good, then how amazing is the original palette? If it was still in stock, if ABH still sold this palette, I would definitely buy it for the full price because I super duper love this palette. So I will go in with this shade on my crease. It's very pigmented, very soft. Next, I think I'm going to go in with color from this palette. We'll start with this one. Oh, wow. I'm gonna cut my crease with this pen, this concealer pen. And it does tend to like tug on the skin a bit. There's like a really bright color in this quad. So I'm gonna try use that. This concealer palette is actually performing a lot better than I anticipated. I think I want to try another shade, so I'm going to go in with
this gray hair. Try to set the concealer
and sort of like blend in the edges over here.
This shade over here. I'm going to go in with this red, the inner corner
and outer corner as well.
That's why I'm going to put the red in this palette here. Go on top with that. This one isn't as pigmented as the one from this other palette. I'm going to go in with this one, this shade here.
Just put that in the center.
This gold here, center, because I really want this part to stand out. Add some of this dark shade at the corner here. So I'm going to go ahead and do this other eye and get back to you guys.
So next we're going to get into eyeliner, and I bought this a little while later when I realized that I hadn't bought a liner this time. Now, if I didn't say, this liner is from Usha's. It says Usha's eyeliner gel. I bought it in Dubois Street and I think it was like 150 or 100. Next, we can get into face. I'm going to start by spritzing my face with the Kiss Beauty Makeup Fix Cinnamon Green Tea. The wording has faded because I have been using this. I absolutely love this. This actually makes your skin feel so hydrated. It does have a little scent to it, but nothing overpowering. So if you don't like scents, I wouldn't recommend it. And I am using the Kiss Beauty Smooth Skin Perfecting Primer. It feels a bit sticky, but sticky is actually good for primers because it gives the foundation something to grab onto. Then from this quad, I'm going to pick up the orange corrector and I'm going to just correct my dark spots. This palette is really, really nice. Do you see how like my spot just like disappeared? I only used this, the contouring shade, so I never really tried these other shades, but I really, really like this palette. And it is the Ambry. Have I been saying the things I've been using? Oh my goodness, no, I haven't. So this eyeshadow palette is the Charm Max 5 color eyeshadow palette. This eyeshadow palette is the Best Color Makeup Kit Perfect Match Color. Then there's the Makeup by Mario. This is just a clear gel. And I am so afraid I'll be going in with this shade over here. It's like a gray, so that's what I'll be using to conceal. Do you guys think I should try this again? Can I just try it like on this patch of my skin? Maybe if I use a beauty blender. This is bad. Like, so I did get two foundations. These are the Kiss Beauty Stay Matte Foundation. I got them in two shades. This would have been too dark for me and this would have been too light for me. I got this also in River Road and it was 50 bob and I really like it because it's super soft. Do you see how red that is? It goes on like super red, but like when you put it on your skin, it changes color to something lighter. Like I've never seen that in a foundation before. So I'm going to go in that shade right there and I'm going to use that to contour. I'm feeling like I want to use that white to highlight. So you guys pray for me. One, I'm gonna use the red one. Next, I'll be going in with this Jose face.
Jose?
Jose? Oh, it's supposed to be an Iman dupe because back here it says Iman Cosmetics New York. I'm just gonna stipple this into my face. I'm going to use the Usha's and an angled brush and then just smudge that in my waterline. Then I'm going to use the same shades that I used on the waterline as well. I'm going to start with the red from the Charm Max 5 color eyeshadow palette. Right between the black and the red, that's why I'm going to go in with this dark brown.
So I'm gonna go in with the bright green from this palette in my inner corner. And go in with this yellow in the center. Just in the center of that color. This mascara, it's a two-in-one. There's a fat side and a skinny side. I don't feel like this mascara is doing much for my lashes. And I think the next step will be bronzing, and I'm going to use this. This is the classic Makeup USA Mineral Press Powder, and this is in the shade number 3. Putting glitter at the center of my lid, just a little bit, and I do have a review on this glitter, and I'll put the link up here. I got this blush and I think it's so pretty. It has this rose shape over here, and this is the Beauty Time Baked Blush. I'm gonna use this highlighter. It's a Kiss Beauty highlighter and in the shade number 1. Spritz my face. This is the Kylie Lip Liner in Posy K. They smell like something that will just make your lips fall off. I feel like my lips are itchy. I don't know if that's in my head. I think I will go in with this lip gloss. I did buy these quite a while ago. I bought 3 of them. They say MAC lip gloss, but they're fake. And the lashes I went with are these ones I got from eBay and eyelashes. I never buy my lashes from River Road because like they're so expensive, and I know I can find them for cheaper. So why would I buy lashes for 500 when I know I can find them for a sock on eBay? Yeah, so I'm just gonna go put this off camera and be right back. That lip liner was, my lips are so like, it feels like my lips are on fire, so I just removed it. I'm never gonna use those. I wouldn't advise you to get them. I think they probably have like some ingredient that could like burn your lips off. I don't know, it feels very, very tingly, and I don't think that makeup should make your skin feel tingly unless it's supposed to. So I just decided to try this Kylie liquid lipsticks. This is in the shade True Brown K, and I just wanted to see how it looks and how it feels. It feels very nice, it feels very, very comfortable. It doesn't go with my eye look, so I'm gonna look for something else to wear, but I just wanted you guys to see what it looks like. So I decided to try this Hanzikai 24-hour waterproof lip gloss, and this is very, very sticky. What if I just wear this by itself? So this is the finished look, and I do have a couple of thoughts on these items, and I have favorites from the things I have used today. Like, I absolutely love this blush. I think it's very, very subtle. It's not in your face red, it's just like that flash of color, that pop of color you need on your cheeks. Another thing that I surprisingly like, I love this so much. I love all the shades. I don't know if I mentioned, but it's in the color number 3, and it just looks like that. This orange is surprisingly very, very good. I think I might even start using this like with my other products because I really, really love this. The coverage is so nice. This was such a randomly good investment. I absolutely love it. Another random thing I like is this Usha's eyeliner gel. I lost my Maybelline gel liner, and I think I found a dupe for it. I'm not sure. The Maybelline one does feel a bit softer, it does go on a bit smoother, but this one is also really good. It's just as black, it's just that it dries down very fast, so you have to be very, very precise and very fast in how you're working. The Maybelline one gives you some time to move the product and then before it dries down, but this dries down very, very fast. Another thing I like is this foundation. For an inexpensive foundation, I feel like it does a really, really good job, and it's not even like a dupe, it's actually from the brand Kiss Beauty, so I feel like my skin looks very, very nice. I do feel like I have product on my face, but not like overpowering. It's very comfortable. It's obviously very hydrating. It also does have very, very good coverage. The only thing is it does oxidize very fast. If there's anything I would highly recommend from all of these things other than this contour shade, would be this. This is really, really good. It just hydrates your skin, it makes your skin feel so good. On a day-to-day basis, I use this setting spray first and then I go in with a mattifying setting spray because this just makes my skin not tight. The other setting sprays, you know, like the point is the Skinavia setting spray, the point is to
mattify your face and keep your makeup like, you know, like snatched. So this helps in like hydrating my face and not making me feel like super tight. So I really like, definitely going to buy more because I think it was like 300. Will it help with the longevity of your makeup? I'm not sure, but I have been using it in conjunction with other things and I find that I like how my makeup fills with this, so that's why this is already over because I really do love this setting spray. Another thing I love is this. I really like this. They're very nice, very soft, very pigmented. You guys saw that. And another thing I love is these shades are all fall shades. I thought that there were shimmer shades, which is really cool and very random. Like, I was so surprised. I didn't know that there were fall shades up until I put them on my lid. I'd already told you guys about this because obviously I have been using this, but another thing I love is this eyeshadow palette. Like, you have your lid color, you have your transition color, you have your crease color, then you have this other shimmer colors to play with. Like, it is so good. It's so pigmented, so nice. It feels absolutely amazing. The shades themselves are very pigmented and the shimmery, and like the other one, this one's a shimmery shades, and I really like this eyeshadow palette. Another thing that I like, this 2-in-1 eye pencil, the dark one and the light one. I actually don't like the dark part because it's a bit too dark for my brows. I like my brows a little bit lighter than they are right now, but I do like this concealer part for when I'm doing my more creative looks, like when I'm doing like during the Halloween series when I did the avatar and all that. This is really good for that because it helps me map out exactly where I'm gonna put like certain shades of paint and things like that. So I really like the concealer part of this Kylie good lipstick. It's nice, it dries very fast, very comfortable. It's not sticky. I didn't wear it for long. I was just wearing it to just like test it out and see how it would feel on my lips. And these lip glasses, I got them quite a while ago, so I don't know if it counts, but to be honest, I've never worn them. I just normally keep them for when I do River Road like look videos. But I absolutely love this. It's not sticky, it's very comfortable, very pigmented. Other ones that are in the tube that are very sticky and you can feel them, like how heavy they are on your lips. This doesn't feel like that. So if you're into glosses, highly recommend this. This one I loved. It just set my face so nicely. It made my face look so nice, so matte. But as you guys can see, I am shining right now, so the effects are not long lasting for this powder, but for a couple of minutes my face looked really nice, so I really did like it. Now for the things that I did not like, I hate this. Do not waste your money on this Iman makeup new pro cons, just useless. Don't do it. Don't waste your money on this is terrible. If you use your finger, if you use a brush, this will not stay on your face. Another thing you can definitely live without, this Kylie Cosmetics lip liners. They were burning my lips. I don't know what that was, but I got so scared. I was like, okay, I don't want to wake up without lips tomorrow, so no. If you even smell these liners, they smell like they're gonna burn your lips off. Another thing that I didn't like is this mascara. I was really excited because of this fine tip. I thought that I could use it on my bottom lashes. Sadly, didn't work out for me. I don't know about this, the Kiss Beauty Smooth Skin Perfecting Primer. I really liked how it felt, but I have oily skin. If you have like dry skin, I feel like this would be really good for you because it is very comfortable and it does feel very hydrating on the skin. And maybe you can get away with it if you have combination skin, mostly if you're dry in the center of your face. Another thing that I did not like, this liquid lipstick from Hanzi Kai. This was very bad. It would have been a really good nude for me with like a brown liner, but it's very sticky. It just feels very uncomfortable and I did not like that, and I would not recommend that you buy this. This was a bit too ashy for me. I'm not sure if it did much when it came to contouring. I feel like there's something there, but I'm not sure if it's because of this or because of this, to be honest. So I feel like that's it for the review of first impressions. I don't know if that's how people normally do it. I don't know if like you're supposed to talk through as what you feel about the product, or you just like summarize it all down at the end. I feel like I did both. You guys let me know what you prefer in the comment section. Anyway, if you did like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Also, don't forget to press that bell, that way you can always know when I upload a video. Thanks for watching and see you all in my next one. Bye.